I bought my wife a robot vacuum for Christmas. It's what she wanted. And then I 3D printed a part to make it work better. I'll explain it all on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of my Patreon supporters. Here's the problem I have with this vacuum. It was low enough to go underneath some of our furniture, like my favorite chair, but in the middle where it sags a little bit, the robot would get stuck and then just shut itself down. So I would then have to go yank this thing out and reset it. And it also did this underneath our couch. It was just low enough to get into the couch and then stick itself and shut it down again. We had it run at night one time and we woke up to it stuck just like this. I flipped it over and I could see a switch on the inside of the front bumper. When this switch is pressed, it reverses direction. This is the same type of switch that's used on 3D printers as an end stop. So there was a gap there, and then on top there was a gap, and once I pressed the bumper and I could hear the switch click, I still had a gap. So I thought maybe I could make a bracket that'll stick up in the air and snap into this groove. So that's what I tried to make. I went to Tinkercad, and this is a very easy design. I just used a bunch of block elements, one that's tall at 120 millimeters, another at a 90 degree angle at 22, one lower at 14 millimeters, and then two little blocks on the end of those to make it into a snap. And this whole bracket is 20 millimeters tall or wide. So I grouped all that together, hoping I got my dimensions right so this thing would snap in place. For this project, I'm going to use the new Protopasta Metal Flake Candy Apple Red. I call it the Chep Candy Apple Red. You know why? Because I'm the one that suggested it to them, and they actually listened. In fact, they had me test some samples early on. So thank you, Protopasta, for listening and giving us Metal Flake Candy Apple Red filament. I love it. I exported the file from Tinkercad and brought it into my favorite slicer, Simplify 3D. This is a very simple design. I decided to print it on my Anycubic Mega I3 at a 50% fill, 0.3 layer height. Here's the temperatures that I use for the HTPLA at a 60 millimeters per second. So this shouldn't take very long to print. And after I sliced it, it looked good, and it said 42 minutes to print this thing. So this should be a very quick fix. And here it is on the Anycubic. It popped off fairly easily, and this candy apple red, just, it glistens. The camera cannot capture how good this looks. So now it was time to snap it on to the robot. So remember that gap on the bottom where that switch was. It fits in there and then snaps over the front onto that lip. And it looks like it's got plenty of travel. I can hear the switch clicking. So hopefully this is gonna work. So now I need to test it on the carpet. I can't believe this thing worked the first time. It hit the bumper on the couch and then it hit the 3D print. And then it went on another angle and it kind of got itself stuck, but it kept hitting the 3D print and reversing direction, which allowed it to get itself free and then move on to the rest of the carpet. So that worked out perfect. It never got itself stuck. Now my chair, it went in straight, hit the 3D print and reverse direction. That's exactly what I wanted it to do. Clean up to the chair, but not go underneath it. So I'm really happy with it. Now I couldn't make it too tall because I have a charging station that's underneath this little table. So I was worried that I might have made it too tall, but it worked perfectly. I'm really happy with the way this worked out. The only improvements I may make is a little bit tighter and then maybe stretch this out with two more prongs coming up but still snap in the same spot. That way it can hit at different angles and still push the switch. So if you like useful 3D print projects like this, maybe check out some of the videos popping up over here. If you want to help support the channel, $1 a month to Patreon goes a long way. And if nothing else, click on that Chep logo popping up and subscribe. That's it for this week. I'll see you next year on Filament Friday.